Welcome to In the Pocket with Johnny Fabulous. That's me. Music and art for your eyes to see, your ears to hear, and your mind to take pleasures in. Isn't that right, ladies? Ooh, it's the ladies. In the Pocket, we're going to bring you the originals, the magical, the creatives, and other nutcases who inspire and color our little world with all the power of the arts. Climb in the pocket with me right now. All right, we are here with Peter Cor. Good to see you, man.
Good to see you, Johnny.
Peter Cor is a songwriter, a fabulous keyboard player. He's a producer. He's a musical director. Sings a little bit, I hear. Never heard you, but
rumor has it.
Yeah, that's right. And Peter, now listen, you've been in Santa Cruz how long?
Since 1994. So it's
94.
16 years.
It's longer than that.
Longer than that.
Yeah, it'd be 18 years, right?
18.
Let's not have a math thing
I'm
right now.
I'm terrible at math.
Yeah.
It's too early.
So, and you still talk like that. So is that a speech impediment or is it an accent?
What are you talking about?
Where are you from originally?
I don't hear any problem. South Carolina, but the northern part, you know? No, Manhattan, New York.
Right on. So, but you did a CD with the Jazzy Devils,
right?
We did
two CDs.
You did two, okay.
And I got distribution deals for both CDs, but like I said, it was right when the music business was
shifting.
Getting turned on its head, and short story long, nothing really happened of any significance.
So you still have a garage full.
Oh, I have, really. Somebody say hoarders, you know?
Actually, we'll be showing the CD covers during the interview here,
because
you're going to send them to me. So, on one of the CDs, there's a song called Getaway.
Correct,
which,
yeah.
Which we're going to take a look at a video you made here locally. It's really neat.
Uh-huh.
But tell me about the song, because this is not the original recording of it.
No.
Some other band had done it before. Can you tell us a little bit about
that? Well, there was this little band that you may have heard of called Earth, Wind, and Fire, and they made it a pretty big hit back in the 76, 77, so it's the Jurassic age for all your young people looking out there. But it was a very big hit, and it was covered by a lot of other artists as well.
Really? Like who?
Lee Ritenour.
Oh.
Tuck and Patty. Tuck did a version. I even saw him perform when Palookaville was still going.
Really?
On. I went and introduced myself, and he played it for me in the concert.
Oh, that's
and
beautiful.
And introduced me to the whole audience before playing it.
What a class
too.
Act he is.
Oh, yeah. And he played the heck out of that song because it's got horns and bass and all that stuff. And he was just able
make
to
make it all happen on the guitar.
Unbelievable.
That's incredible. So it must be a thrill to have somebody cover one of your songs and to hear it done by different acts.
Oh, it's
there's got to be quite a rush, huh?
It's very interesting. Another cover version was done with Lenny White, the jazz drummer.
Oh, right.
Who had Ron Carter on bass and Patrice Rushen on keyboards.
Mm-hmm.
And they did a jazzy album of all Earth, Wind, and Fire tunes.
Wow.
And they did my tune amongst those. But it was funny, I could hardly recognize it because they would start a little bit of the theme and then they would just jazz out.
Yeah.
And you go, what happened here? But, you know, I'm not going to complain.
So a friend of mine calls the jazz the definition of the inexact.
That's a pretty good definition.
Sometimes I don't know what the hell's going on. All right, let's take a look at Peter Cor.
So if I can just say something about this clip. This was filmed here in Santa Cruz.
Mm-hmm.
And what's interesting about this, the song, was my band did the version of it, but I hired Ronnie Laws as the sax player to play on it. Now, Ronnie Laws is just a world-famous jazz musician who lives in L.A., and as we were recording it and I was talking to him, it turns out ironically, he was the original horn player in Earth, Wind, and Fire's first formula. They had a chick in there, but the album didn't do anything. They weren't well known. So he decided to leave the band because he didn't think they were going to do anything.
Yeah. Hey, I'm not taking any calls, by the way. Sorry. Yeah.
So I thought, you know, learning about it as we're working in the studio just kind of blew my mind. You know what I mean? It was just like coming full circle.
Yeah. You know? Yeah. Wow, that's a neat little extra.
Yeah. So he's playing sax on it, you know, and it was all filmed around the West Side, most of it in the Lighthouse area, because I wanted to get, you know, the Santa Cruz vibe.
That's great place to get away. Let's take a look right now. We'll be right back. Well, that was great. Getaway, man. Nice fun. Seeing the sights of Santa Cruz. Very, very cool. We have another clip we're going to show in a few minutes called Raven Mad. But before we get to that, I want to ask you about your songwriting. How old were you when you first started writing songs?
Oh, geez. I was in my early teens. Mm-hmm. And I had studied a lot of classical music when I was younger. I started around 5, 6. And, you know, by the time I was 12, 13, and, you know, rock and roll and everything was happening, and it just kind of pulled me into a different direction.
Yeah.
And that's when I just started experimenting, you know, how you do in the beginning. You're just throwing up stuff and seeing what sticks to the wall, you know, and it's a never-ending process.
Right.
You know, you just keep doing it and finding, refining stuff, you know, and try to add to your repertoire of tools that you use for composing. And, you know, I've also studied arranging and, you know, theory and stuff like that to give you some kind of knowledge theoretically that can also help you branch out. It's a tool.
So you can write a horn chart or a string chart, no problem.
I took a big band arranging class up at Cabrillo.
Oh, Ray Brown's class.
Fantastic. And I had to write for 15 horns.
Wow.
I almost had a nervous breakdown doing that, man. But I got through it, you know.
You got more tools.
Yes.
Very good. So we've got this tune that we're going to show in a moment called Raven Mad. And it was actually filmed on, Look, Mom, I'm on TV. It's a community television show. And it's an electronica thing.
Correct.
Which when I popped this up on YouTube and I started watching, I thought, oh, heavens, my audience will like this because they're friends of Mary. And it's it's a kind of a wild visual thing. And then you've got some really interesting music going along with it.
Well, I got into what's called looping about 6-7 years ago. There's a really good festival here, Loop Festival, that's
run by... Gary Regina is a part of it.
Well, Rick Walker is the guy who runs it.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I went there just curious, and then I ended up participating, and I did about 5 of them. And I really got into working in that medium because it's one of the few areas where there is no rule that you can break. There are no rules. And so you don't worry as much about the theory or structure of a song. It's more a vibe thing.
Yeah.
You know. And so for me, it was cool to get into that just to get away from the more structured thing. And really, you're like a painter. You start with a blank canvas and you don't know what's going to happen. So this is part of a CD I did called Into the Light. You can check it all out on petercor.com. It's got everything up there. But so I did this live, the whole album, with my looper and playing live guitar and keyboards. And I created the special effects that they were able to insert through the canvas.
The visual.
So you can see it while I'm playing. You see the effects. And that turned out really well. That was an experiment for me just to see, hey, what's it going to be like? You know, it worked out really good.
Yeah. All right. We're going to take a look at Raven Mad. Bob, you're going to like this one. So spark it up. You'll enjoy it. Here's Raven Mad, Peter Cor.
Thank you.
We are back once again with Peter Cor. We just took a look at Raven. Man, that was wild.
Pretty Raven.
Pretty nutty. Pretty nutty. Anyhow, one of the things that Peter and I are both involved in is the Young at Heart Project. I've been working with him for, 15 plus years.
Wow.
And you've been doing a few years.
2 years now.
And what it is we do one-hour shows at senior homes, convalescent facilities, Alzheimer's units. And it's a powerful thing, music is. And to be able to take folks someplace else for an hour, especially if they've lost mobility, can't drive, or maybe they're in a wheelchair, and to play the songs that they love and bring joy to them is part of my joy in life. And it's been a real trip for you to get involved with this.
Huh? Oh, yeah. Sean, the director, approached me about doing it, and I honestly didn't think I had the skills necessary to do this type of presentation, sing and play piano for an hour. That's not really what I've been doing in my career. I usually, accompany people in the band, but doing solo stuff with vocals and a piano,
It's a different thing, huh?
It's totally different. Just the experience of the exchange between the residents and what you're doing is like priceless, you know?
Yeah, it's rich.
I think the most striking experience I've had up to now was playing in an Alzheimer's ward.
Mm-hmm.
And going in there was about 25 residents in wheelchairs, all slumped over, and there was no life, they were lifeless, so to speak. And when the music started, they slowly kind of bloomed like flowers.
Yeah, yeah.
And by the end of the show, some of them were up and dancing with some of the aides. And it was blowing me away, because as I was doing the show, it was happening, and I was just trying to maintain.
And you're just watching.
I'm watching. Yeah. It's like, wow, this is unbelievable. And that's something I'll never forget.
Yeah, that's incredible. One time I was in San Jose doing a gig, and I was doing a Nat King Cole, tribute to Nat King Cole at that time. And a lady came up to me after the show, and she said, when I was a little girl, I used to sit around the radio with my mom and dad, and we would sing along with Nat King Cole on the radio. And she said, when you were doing those songs, I felt like my parents were right here with me.
Wow, yeah.
Anybody, I dare you. And what we perform at these senior communities, sometimes it's for 10 people, sometimes it's for 100.
Yeah.
But the power of music is always the same. So, Peter, I want to say thanks for
being
in the pocket with me.
Keep doing it.
And we're gonna.
Thanks for having me.
A pleasure. This guy is awesome. If you get a chance to see Peter Cor, check him out at petercor.com. And, of course, he's on Facebook, like the rest of us.
Yeah.
And I want you to take a look at this wonderful video from the Young at Heart Project. Thanks again, huh?
All right, man.
I've been playing piano since I was very little, like 3-4 years old. My mother said I discovered sound in the piano. I've been playing ever since. The Young at Heart Project has been such a profound influence and effect on so many lives, and bringing joy and taking people somewhere.
You're lovely.
And if I can take them someplace for an hour through the power of music, I drive away knowing I've done my job and that maybe some angel's work has occurred.
There is nothing for me but to love you.
Music is the universal language, in my view. Music has been shown in scientific studies to connect to parts of the brain that conversation doesn't reach, that even reasoning doesn't relate to. Young at Heart musicians are always top quality and very, very responsive to the residents. They understand them, they interact with them in a really positive way.
I didn't think you saw me.
Oh, of course I did. And I heard you too.
Why, yeah.
Yeah, you sounded good. You sounded good. You've been singing all your life, huh?
I thought he was going to ask me to sing a little song.
Well, you could right now.
No.
I'll see.
No,
yeah, you're just teasing us.
Fairy tales can come true.
My name is Sean Seaman. I'm with Young at Heart, and I feel very lucky to be the founder and the artistic director of a program that has brought the joy and healing power of music to over 100,000 residents of the Bay Area. We've done 30,000 performances, and I'm proud to say that we're going to be doing many more with your help. For 30 years, what we've tried to do is present performances and themes that really touched our given audience. We've had everything from accordion players to violin players, guitar players, to, of course, the most favorite, the piano player.
I took piano lessons from the time I was 10 till I was 13, and my teacher moved away, so the next step seemed logical to just start playing for church at 13.
Same old witchcraft when you're out.
For me, it's a pleasure. But once I get to the facility and set up and start playing the music, I just feel very, very happy.
The way you wear your hat, the way you sip your tea.
I think a good show is having people feel a personal connection to who I am and where I've come from, and that they feel like I care about them and who they are. That it be entertaining, make them smile, take them away for 45 minutes or an hour.
No, they can't take that away from me.
It makes me feel so happy inside. I feel like I'm so, just want to get up and dance. And I wish I could.
I love music. There's nothing like music. And so there.
When the moon hits you right like a big pizza pie, that's amore.
I believe that this is one of the most worthwhile things I've done. In terms of reaching people that a lot of others are not doing. We're providing something very unique with Young at Heart, which is professional entertainment. We get by and we can continue only on your support, so we ask you to please, out of the goodness of your hearts, donate to this wonderful organization and help us be able to keep doing these shows and help change and touch lives.
And if you should survive to 105, is anybody 105?
I think I'm getting on there.
You're getting on there, all right. Think of all you derive out of being alive. Here is the best part. You had a head start. If you are among the very young at heart. If you are among the very young at heart. And we are among the very young at heart. Thank you very much, everyone. God bless you.
Thank you so much.
Hope to see you again.
That's our show. I knew you'd dig it. In the Pocket with Johnny Fabulous. You can find us on Facebook. Also, all the shows are up on YouTube and probably some other places on the interwebs. I don't know. Anyhow, we love your comments, your feedback. Come say hello to us on Facebook at In the Pocket with Johnny Fabulous. And we'll see you next trip.
All right, let's get out of here.